from Guaranteed Rate Field on the south side of Chicago. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Minnesota Twins going up against the Chicago White Sox. First pitch coming your way next. Here on the south side, Luis Arraez stands in. On the ground, right side, and foul ball. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Puts it away for the out. Here's Byron Buxton. Pretty amazing athlete this guy is. Power and speed, quite a threat. I mean, you're talking about someone that could steal your bag and go deep. Bo Jackson, anyone? That one in for a strike, 2-2.
When you have a real athletic player and who's able to do the baseball mechanical things really well, look out, because the sky's the limit on that potential.
Next pitch misses way outside. And he walked him.
Now, this was a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Runner on at first with one gone. Carlos Correa, the next Twin up to hit. Next offering upstairs. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. There's the ball. Throw to second. Ow! The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. And it's filled up. Pitch and fouled off.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
Kicks and fires. So now two on and two outs. First and second, two down. Max Kepler at the plate. And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pop up right side, foul territory. Sheets racing over to make the catch. Bottom of the first, here's Tim Anderson. It's amazing. We get a chance to talk to a lot of opposing managers. This guy scares managers on the other team as much as anyone.
And he gets to fly beneath the radar with the other more recognizable names in this lineup.
The wind to kick the pitch. And down on strikes. And now one away. Andrew Vaughn now.
The designated hitter.
And the righty deals. Oh, this is deep to left center. Way back there. On its way. Gone. He flexes his power with that swing. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0. So digging in, Luis Robert. A guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. Next offering upstairs.
Part of the order coming through now. And with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
And now it's even up. Next pitch is outside. And that's ball four. Jose Abreu up to hit.
Batting for the first baseman, Jose Abreu.
Archer throws to first. Robert dives back in. And he deals. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Two away. Yoan Moncada with a chance to hit.
Yoan Moncada.
Robert on the go. Pitch in for a strike. Sanchez throws. Too late. Stolen base. Man on second, two down. Tap to first. He steps on the bag. They limit the damage here. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field, here's Alex Kirilloff. The pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Robert racing over to make the catch. Gio Urshela steps in.
Batting seven, the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
And the next pitch is way outside. That misses the zone. Ball three. Right-hander kicks, deals. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
And here comes the power-hitting catcher, Gary Sanchez. Swing and a miss. 2-2. And that one gets away at the plate. He is safe. One out and a runner at second. And he grounds one back up the middle. Harrison fires over to first. He's out. And now the Minnesota designated hitter, Jose Miranda.
The designated hitter, Jose Miranda.
And a 1-1. And that's outside. Good eye in that spot.
Love how this guy grinds out at bats. I mean, he's down there at the bottom of the lineup in the nine hole, but he's worked himself into a really good hitter's count trying to pick up a two-out RBI.
3-2 now. That's the third. Moncada tossed to first. Out number three. Welcome back. Bottom of the second. A.J. Pollock at the dish. Next pitch inside. And a count 2-1. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. The 2-2 now. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. One away. And now the right fielder, Gavin Sheets.
The right fielder.
The 1-1.
Sheets.
There's a line drive to left field. And that one hops the wall. Sheets into second, and he's got a double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
Now here is Josh Harrison. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That's back there. makes the catch, crashing into the wall.
No, that takes a lot of concentration to haul it in when you know that wall is about to stop you in your tracks. Really nice play and nice focus right there.
And here it comes. And a swing and a miss. And that ends the inning. And welcome back. And here's the first baseman, Luis Arraez. Ground ball, Abreu. And he takes it himself for the out. And now here is Byron Buxton. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
Here's Carlos Correa. And a pitch. Now you see even sluggers from time to time try and use the bunt really as a way to beat the shift. Next offering is fouled back. Stays alive. 2-2 now. Good eye right there. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Back here at the ballpark, here's the shortstop at the plate, Tim Anderson. The other way, and base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Next pitch, way upstairs. Rips that one center field. That's a hit. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
Now batting,
Luis Robert steps to the plate for the White Sox. Good contact guy, good defender. On the ground, a second, might be two. There's one, double play. That was some defensive wizardry. Jose Abreu steps to the plate for the White Sox.
Up next to Chicago. The first baseman, Jose Abreu.
The 1-2. And a ball evens the count. Two down. Got him. And that is the inning. Here on the south side, and now Jorge Polanco. Next offering is in for a strike. Now that's smacked to right center. He can't get there, it's a base hit. And the tying runs at second base with a double.
Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball, and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow-through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time.
Now batting Max Kepler. That one out to right. Cheeks under it. And puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tags up for third. Safe. He beats it. Alex Kirilloff digs in now.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion. and he's in full speed.
That's a base hit. Run scores.
Gets it done to drive in the run and tie it back up. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Gio Urshela to the plate, and now the count is even. Up the middle. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield. The throw is wild and it gets away. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds at second with one gone.
Up next for the Twins.
And Gary Sanchez at the plate. Next pitch misses inside. 2-1.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming. He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Next offering way off the plate. One out. Runners at first and second. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Pretty good spot on the outside, but just couldn't quite clip the zone. That's a stone cold take.
And next for Minnesota, Jose Miranda. Righty delivers. That one fouled off.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next pitch misses way outside. One out, base is full. Next pitch is popped up. Luis Arraez now at the plate.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Out to center. Robert moving under it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Back here on the south side. And now Yoan Moncada. Next pitch is outside. Out there to center. Buxton drifts towards it. One up, one down. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
The wind of the pitch. Fouled off. He was late. One down. Base is empty. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's the second out. And up next for Chicago, Gavin Sheets.
Gavin Sheets.
The wind of the pitch. Way upstairs. And it's 2-1.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
Next offering misses, and that's ball three. Swing, and that's ripped towards right center. Kepler makes the catch, and that'll do it. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Jimmy Lambert.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back at Guaranteed Rate Field, new inning getting started, and now for the Twins, Byron Buxton. The pitch. And a swing and a miss down on strikes, and the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth.
The batter.
And now Carlos Correa. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. Right-handed reliever. Ripped on a line. Sheets makes the grab. And there are two outs. Now the Minnesota cleanup hitter, Jorge Polanco. One for one with a double and a run scored. And the right-hander's 3-1. Out to short. Zips it to first. And that is that. Welcome back. Now it's the second baseman, Josh Harrison. That's inside. Line to left. And that one gets down, fair ball. And that's going to get into the corner. The throw into second. In there, that's a double.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Just a really nice job of punting on that pitch and smoking it down the line. And there's no one playing there, so once it drops in fair, you're on your way to extra bases.
Next pitch is popped up. Arise. Settles underneath it. One down. Tim Anderson steps to the plate for the White Sox. One for one. He led off the bottom of the first with a single. Runner leads away at second. That's in there. And it's second. Just misses. And it's 2-2. Kicks and deals. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. Three, two on the way. Up the middle, Polanco over to pick it up. In plenty of time to first, and they take care of Anderson for the out. And now the DH, Andrew Vaughn.
Now batting, the designated hitter.
Runner at third, two away.
Vaughn.
Line drive. Buxton makes the play, and that'll do it. And welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. And now, Max Kepler. Next pitch inside. And it's 2-1. Line drive, and that's a base hitter to right. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Here comes a pitch. Way high with that one. 3-1.
Well, on this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
Now this one's crushed down the line. Hooking. Foul ball.
Well, that ball's hit pretty hard and sure had home run distance, but if you're the pitcher out there on the mound, you execute it. Just a long strike. You go after him and finish him off.
Swing and a high fly ball to left. Pollard gets there. He's under it. Calls it in, and there's one away. Here's Gio Urshela.
Now batting. Third baseman, Gio Urshela.
And the right-hander deals in the dirt, and now 3-2.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
3-2. Swing and a slow roller. Over to Abreu. Two away.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front. Rolled over on it. Now exactly what he was supposed to do.
It's Gary Sanchez. And a pitch. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And the inning is over. Back here at the ballpark, and now it's Luis Robert.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
And a swing and a line drive into right field. Dives, but it falls. Could be extra bases. And that's a leadoff double.
He got a pitch he could drive, but he didn't get too excited like a lot of guys do and pull off the baseball. Really good timing all the way through the swing, and the barrel was so on plane with the ball. Easy drive into the gap for that double. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Two-two. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Here is Moncada. He's 0 for 1.
Moncada.
The pitch.
Well, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
That one drifts inside. Righty to the plate. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Brings it in. Two away.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but a competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Next offering is down low. The 2-1. Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. He'll circle the bases, and they jump out front. It's 3-1. Gavin Sheets will hit next. 0-for-1 so far. And a count 1-2. Softly hit to third. Urshela to first in time. And that is the inning. Here on the south side, all set for the start of the inning. Now it's the Twins DH, Jose Miranda. One one now. They say it went. Out towards right center field. Sheets on the move to the alley. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. And here's the Twins leadoff guy, Luis Arraez.
The first baseman, Luis Arraez.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Robert makes the play. Two down. Now it's the power speed combo. Byron Buxton. This guy is one of the best athletes in the sport. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. And that one fouled off. Mm-hmm. two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And the Twins go 1-2-3. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh, number 48. And he'll do his best to keep this close.
Tyler Thornburg.
Back here on the south side, bottom of the seventh. Here's the second baseman, Josh Harrison. Next offering down in the dirt. In the air, right field, Kepler going back, back some more. Puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down. Now here's Reese McGuire. There's a 1-1. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. Got him. Two gone after the strikeout. And the batter will be the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. Next pitch is in the dirt, 3-1.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits. One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Next offering is in for a strike. Check on the runner. Anderson dives back. This one chopped up the middle. And he can't come up with it. He decides to hold on to it, and they don't get an out on the play. Now Luis Robert now, fielder, 1-for-2. At the belt and fires. That one down the line. That's a fair ball, and it's getting into the corner. And that goes into the corner. Relay throw home. It's off the mark, and he scores. And they lead by four.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. Pitches away, and he did exactly what you're supposed to do with it. Drive it the other way. Just go with the pitch.
New pitcher on here, Jarrell Cotton. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there. So, man aboard. Now here's the cleanup hitter for the White Sox, Jose Abreu, who's 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts. Ground ball, left side. Urshela to first in time. And that'll keep more runs from coming in. Inning over. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field. Ready to begin the eighth. And now for the Twins, Carlos Correa. The pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Makes the grab on the run. And there's one away. The batter now, Jorge Polanco.
Now batting, second baseman, Jorge Polanco.
They say it went. Ripped to right, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands now whatsoever. Right. Such a good feeling. Matt. Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And here is Max Kepler. Next offering is fouled back. Here comes a 3-2. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And a payoff pitch. And that one fouled off. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Ground ball right side, could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. Over to first, safe. So up next for Minnesota, Alex Kirilloff, one for three.
Alex Kirilloff.
Lifted in the air, right center field. Drops in for a hit, couldn't run it down. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two now away. Back. New pitcher first for the White Sox, Joe Kelly. And he'll work on holding this lead.
Please. Now pitching for the White Sox, number 17, Joe Kelly.
Gio Urshela, the next twin up to hit. Now all even up. Next offering misses down and away. Payoff pitch. And they're all loaded up.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Gary Sanchez at the plate. Kicks and fires. Stays alive. Bases loaded, two down. Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. On the ground, right side. Fires over to first. That's the third out. Welcome back. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now here is Yoan Moncada. The wind and the pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off the 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
And at first, A.J. Pollock, the next to hit. The 2-1. And he walked him.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boo.
Now batting, right fielder.
Now it's the right fielder, Gavin Sheets. First and second here, no outs. Next pitch is outside.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Next one misses, and that's ball three.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Left-hand hitter waits. Got him looking. Now one away. Two on with one out. Josh Harrison getting ready to hit.
Josh Harrison.
And the righty deals.
Nope.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Two on, one out. And down on strikes he goes. And two away now. Reese McGuire steps to the plate for the White Sox.
Reese McGuire.
Two outs. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. Foul ball. The 1-2. Now he can't squeeze it behind the plate. To third, not in time. He's safe. It's second and third with two gone. And a 2-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Matt Foster will take over here, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Number 63, Matt Foster.
And welcome back. And now, Jose Miranda. The Twins in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at-bat out of him right here.
And a foul ball. And a 1-2. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Next to hit, Luis Arraez.
Luis Arraez.
And he deals. Smoked to the left, base hit.
I'm sure that feels pretty good after going hitless in this one so far. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Next to hit, Byron Buxton. Next offering clips the zone count even at 2.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
Pitch misses inside, and the count's full. In the air to left center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. And at first. And here comes Carlos Correa. Three-two now. Into center. Robert moving under this one. And that is the ball game.
I don't care if you're a top team or you're a middle of the pack team. Every ball club wants to be dominant at home. Winning a game like this just helps to boost the confidence and makes you look forward to coming out again for the next one.
5-1 is how it ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Score tonight. First for the victorious White Sox. 5 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 7 men on base.